Good evening and welcome to our first reflection for Holy Week on this Monday evening. Each of the reflections will be a Bible reading and a thought. We will sing a song. We'll have 2 minutes of silence as we pray, and then we'll close with some liturgy from Compline together. Let's begin. Tonight's reading is from John 12, verses 1 to 11. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany where Lazarus lived, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. Here a dinner was given in Jesus' honour. Martha served while Lazarus was among those reclining at the table with him. Then Mary took about a pint of pure nard, an expensive perfume. She poured it on Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with her hair. As the house was filled with the fragrance of the perfume, one of his disciples, Judas Iscariot, who was later to betray him, objected. Why wasn't this perfume sold and the money given to the poor? It was worth a year's wages. He did not say this because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. As keeper of the money bag, he used to help himself to what was into it. Leave her alone, Jesus replied. It was intended that she should save this perfume for the day of my burial. You will always have the poor among you, but you will not always have me. Meanwhile, a large crowd of Jews found that Jesus was there and came, not only because of him, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests made plans to kill Lazarus as well. For on account of him, many of the Jews were going over to Jesus and believing in him. This was not an ordinary meal. This dinner was a celebration, a thank you for the life of Lazarus, whom Jesus had brought back to life. And in John's account, Lazarus' sister Mary takes perfume valued in today's terms at about a year's wages, and she pours it over Jesus' feet, wiping his feet with her hair. Now, the nard from this perfume was only found, in fact, in the mountains of Nepal and only over 3,000 feet. That means that it was incredibly valuable. It would have been enough money to have kept her and her family for life. Maybe they pooled the money, or maybe this was a family heirloom passed down. Mary would have let her hair down to do this. And it was an altogether unexpected and fairly embarrassing encounter for the other guests at the party. What Mary did was an all-in, fully committed, no expense spared, extravagant act of thanks and worship. She must have had a prophetic sense of what was coming for Jesus, an event that was only days away, that Jesus also knew was coming. She entered into the pain of Jesus's rejection and humiliation. And at that moment, her focus totally was on Jesus and this act of both worship and consecration. I wonder what Jesus is worth to us. For Mary, this was a lavish expression of love and gratitude. She gave everything that she had to Jesus. At the start of Holy Week, we might like to think about whether we are willing to surrender everything that we have and all that we are to Jesus. We're going to sing now together.
Riches of this world will fade. Treasures of our God remain. Here I empty myself to all this world nothing, and find everything in you. Riches of this world will fade.
This passage that I've read this evening comes at the beginning of Holy Week, or this final movement, as Malcolm Geat describes in his poem. And I'm going to read his poem for us this evening. It's entitled The Anointing at Bethany. Come close with Mary, Martha, Lazarus. So close the candles flare with their soft breath and kindle heart and soul to flame within us. Lit by these mysteries of life and death. For beauty now begins the final movement. In quietness and intimate encounter, the alabaster jar of precious ointment is broken open for the world's true lover. The whole room richly fills to feast the senses with all the yearning such a fragrance brings. The heart is mourning, but the spirit dances. Here at the centre of all things, here at the meeting place of love and loss, we all foresee and see beyond the cross. We're going to have 2 minutes now just of silent prayer, and then we're going to close together with the words of Compline, which will appear on your screen. We're going to close this evening with the words, with some of the words from Compline, which will be on the screen. So let's say this together. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. In peace we will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give us peace this night. Amen.